Jumbo, good morning, good afternoon. Today is Sunday, July 5th, 2020. Here at First Community Investment Incorporated, located 219 Hamilton, Rochester, New York, in the South Wedge. We're just down the street from us, at the Park of Alexander, there's a statue of the gentleman who founded the city of Rochester. And I recently learned it was a slave owner. Go figure that one out. That's another conversation at a time. Okay, we lost an icon in the local political scene this past week, referring to treasures of Assemblyman David Gantt from the Institute. I'll do that later on. I have a new format for us to Doology Hour. It's a presentation format. Everything is written out. This is a basic program. We have the welcome by National Anthem, scripture readings, prayer of hope, libation of Harlem Renaissance, news update, Bible summary, policy statement, memoriam, morning silence, announcement of thank yous, Psalm 23, and our four closing songs. Okay, and everything should work a little smoother. So more organized, I can sit down and have a more coherent, structured program. Okay, we're gonna open up with Ray Charles versus the Black National Anthem. Amen. Rest in peace, Ray Charles. Rest in peace. Okay, I'm Susie Monaone, trustee and treasurer here at First Community Events Incorporated. I'm your host for today's First Student Lunch Hour. Okay. This past week, we also observed the 15th anniversary of the Church of Luther Vandross, who was one of Minister Evans' favorite singers. And this week, past week, was the 95th anniversary of the birth of Mega Evers. Amen, amen, amen. Our three scripture readings are from the book of Isaiah. First one is Isaiah 26, verse 20, our quarantine verse. It reads as follows. Come, my people, enter thou into thy chambers, and shut thy doors about thee. Hide thyself for a little moment until indignation be overpast. Next other verse is Isaiah 41, verse 10. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. Yea, I'll uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Amen. And our last verse is a new verse I came across while scrolling through Minister Evans' Bible. And he had this particular verse circled, Isaiah 40, verse 31. And it reads as follows. But they that wait for Jehovah shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Amen. May the Lord bless those readings of His holy word. Amen. Next up is Minister Evans' classic poem, Prayer of Hope. 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 This is our prayer of hope. Creator, may I talk with you? A need for possibly sure. It's our prayer of hope. This is our prayer of hope. To make us feel this oppression is gone. Society is no longer in the midst of chaos and conflict. This is our prayer of hope. We know that our kinds of view is how we see ourselves. There's a need for impossible leadership. This is our prayer of hope. This is in truth lighting the way. This is our prayer of hope. The opponent's propaganda of naming human relations has caused many of us to talk. Instead of thinking about the change that have taken place. This is our prayer of hope. Lord, same dehumanizing oppression, brutality, sex, class, citizenship of yesterday have reconstructed itself to a new form of mechanism, namely the perpetuation of brainwashed black people to accept oppression, brutality, same class citizenship in name of reconciliation. This is our prayer of hope. We know that all kinds of view. You see how we see ourselves. There's need for more positive leadership. This is a prayer of hope. This is the truth laying away. This is a prayer of hope. 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 This is our prayer of hope. Amen. Okay, we'll do next harm libation, which is libation of the harm renaissance. Things we're reading before the pandemic. It's the 100th anniversary of the harm renaissance. We honor Lance Hughes, the poet, Ashea Shea. I know it's a painter, Ashea Shea. James Will Johnson, who composed the voice of Sing, Ashea Shea. Dorothy West, the writer, Ashea Shea. Amen. And all these folks are featured in this book, The Pueblo Harlem Renaissance Reader. Amen. Our news update is taken from June 28th, Amsterdam News. And we're going to deal with a health issue that's that affects our community pretty hard. Dementia. We have instances of dementia within the Institute circle over the years. Mr. Fick, you just know, has dementia. His lovely wife, sister Renee, is his caretaker. And he's in a state where he has pretty much be under 24/7 supervision. Okay, as you remember, may recall Ms. McKinney, who owned a grocery store in Plymouth Avenue many years. On his final years, he suffered dementia, and he had him in St. John's home. And a month before he passed, he came to our Kwanzaa feast with his daughter, Sister Geraldine. I forget what year that was, but no longer that, he passed away, and Ms. Evans did his eulogy at his homegoing. Okay, may he rest in peace, Ms. McKinney. And my Uncle Fitzy in Brooklyn, who passed from COVID earlier this year, he had dementia, severe dementia. He was in a nursing home when he got sick with the COVID. May he rest in peace as well. And I'm sure we all know folks. We've seen folks with dementia in our community. We know folks in our families or have know of people with dementia. Okay. And this article is written by Dr. Lucille Rigill, R-I-D-G-I-L-L, and she's a physician based in California. And her article reads as follows. One second. Alzheimer's disease, the most common type of dementia, is the sixth leading cause of death among white people, but the fourth leading cause of death for black people like me. The black population age 65 plus is projected to more than double in size in the next 10 years, which means dementia diagnosis in our community also could more than double the number. Dementia is called a quote, some epidemic, unquote, among black people, because many of us refuse to acknowledge or discuss this horrific disease. As a physician who has a close family member to who's really diagnosed with dementia, I feel the great loss was ever decreasing. Communication with my loved one, and that is very painful. Its decreasing toll is also due to untreated or inadequately treated hypertension and diabetes causing vascular dementia. Its occurrence is due to the progressive destruction of the vascular supply, that means the blood vessels. The disease progresses slowly so that family members and physicians are shocked when it becomes apparent. Unfortunately, there's not much you can do to prevent Alzheimer's at this time, but you can check your glucose and blood pressure regularly and take antihypertensive and diabetes medications as prescribed to the layer to prevent vascular dementia. It's important to make sure family members understand their susceptibility and take action as necessary. Failure to do so can lead to delayed medical care and caregiver burden of family members. One major reason black people suffer disproportionately from Alzheimer's is we are underrepresented in dementia research, in part because many of us are unwilling to donate our brains to research or participate in brain studies to distrust our medical system. The good news is that this problem is dissipating as more physicians and healthcare workers of color and the healthcare system. Another reason is that people suffer disproportionately from diseases linked to high risk of dementia, including high blood pressure and type 2 diabetes. So the disease that black folks most are impacted with, hypertension, diabetes, heart disease, those type of diseases are risk factors for dementia. The black community must demand that lawmakers significantly increase financial support resources, to reduce dementia among people of color. We also must take personal responsibility for improving our eating habits and lifestyle to reduce accessibility to it. If fresh fruits and vegetables are not available where you live, you buy an increasingly available farmer's market or grow them in your garden, creating exercise activity, or providing you with good, healthy food. However, since dementia is incurable, we also must do advanced planning for the care we would want in case we do get dementia, so we don't have to suffer needlessly but involuntarily receiving treatments. We don't want to artificially extend our life during the last, most debilitating stages of dementia. For example, when we lost everything that matters to us, the memory of our loved ones, of our life, our identity, and ability to speak. In fact, people with dementia may endure implanted defibrillators, mechanical ventilation, feeding tubes, and other invasive interventions, all given with the intention to extend life, but often at the cost of diminished quality of life and prolonged suffering. Even seemingly simple treatments like chest x-rays, urine samples, blood draws, and hospital transfers may become uncomfortable in the face of cognitive impairment. So basically, dementia is a progressive disease. Although I believe there's medication for like the early stages, as well it progresses to the point that person needs constant care. Some folks end up in a nursing home because of dementia, because family members can no longer handle it. So, and folks get health-wise, they deteriorate. So it's very important as we try to take care of ourselves now, so we end up with dementia. And the article is entitled, once again, "But People Suffer Disproportionately from Dementia Crisis," by Lucille Richard. I'll put a link on above in the video. Amen. Very interesting article. Okay, weekly ball summary. Brother Brian went to Peter Ball's this week, but didn't go to Wegmans. So we had a ball summary on July 19th. Policy statement. Reads as follows. First Community Interface Incorporated is a spiritual and cultural station and teaching church that promotes development of African people. We're not such agency, nor a civil welfare agency. Our purpose is not to save anyone, but to enhance our people's liberation and self-determination. We try the idea that we're a community leader can be the people who do not follow. We support our leaders by actions and intensive programs. We refuse to give anyone a religion or an ideology. Our goal is to develop duality for African people. Religious bigotry is not accepted. There's one religion is the truth. This reality is duology. Our programs and services fail for the welfare of our people. We should respond to demands of our member supporters, our constituency. Only our constituency has the right to make demands on us. Amen. That's our policy statement. July 1st, we lost someone, David Gantt. He was very close friend of Minister Evans. He supported the Institute, he supported the soil program. He was one of our ball donors. His granddaughters, the Sizer sisters, were in our tutorial program for a couple of years. He married just about all the Democratic black political figures in Rochester, including the league. I read a couple of statements. First one I read is from Speaker Carl E. Heasty, the Assembly Speaker for New York Government, June July 1st. It's with great sadness that I joined my colleagues in mourning the death of the longtime New York Assembly's Rochester delegation, David F. Gantt. He was a lifelong public servant and first advocate for his constituents and his community. He had an unwavering commitment people of Rochester, was shown every step of his career, from his time as youth councilor in Rochester, serving on the Monroe County Legislature as one in 3 decades, serves here in the Assembly. He was committed to improving people's lives, and ensuring that every New Yorker had the opportunity to succeed. He was a friend and mentor, and I'll dearly miss him. I know I speak for all my Assembly colleagues, and succeed in extending my heartfelt condolences and prayers to family and friends. May he rest in peace. King Brother Lee also had a statement before on social media. I read that as well. This is from July 1st. President Assemblyman David Gantt offers a moment to reflect on his life and the doors he opened in the Great Rochester community. protege of 1983, Monroe County did not have any African-American representation at the state level. Part of the reasons for this was the way the legislative boundaries were drawn to associate short African-Americans. This change went on to May 18, 1982. Congressman David Gantt stated, quote, "We think we have been discriminated against and feel we have to speak up to correct it. We intend to use every legal means at our disposal," quote. He spoke up in support of the community. Fair boundaries were drawn by federal court order. In 1982, Congressman David Gantt was going to become Assemblyman Member Chairman Gantt, excuse me, and the rest is history. May this trailblazer rest in peace. That's why I put him in the office. See, I mailed a Cindy card to his family on behalf of the Institute. He'll be sorely missed. Whoever replaces him in Albany have big shoes to fill. I also acknowledge those in our community who have passed from COVID. In particular, a young woman from Chicago. Her name is Lenika Strozier. She's a biologist. She was 35 years old. She passed June 7th. She was born in Birmingham, Alabama. Moved to Chicago as an infant. She was raised by her grandmother. She had a learning disability, but despite that, she wanted to graduate from Truman College with an associate degree, bachelor's degree in biology, master's degree in biology from Loyola University, and also master's science education from the University of Chicago. And when she was in grad school, her focus was on DNA sequencing to identify new species of plants and birds. Before she passed away, she was a professor at Michael College in Chicago, and she managed the science lab and bio-art lab at School of the Art Institute in Chicago. And she's survived by her grandmother. May she rest in peace. Also, I'd like to acknowledge, as of July 3rd, a total of 273 people in Monroe County who passed from COVID, and especially the 130,000 plus Americans, 130,000 Americans who transitioned from COVID, total, as of today, probably 131,000 by now, under your non-mask wearing presence watch. So have a moment of silence, please. Amen. I'm going to go to Assemblyman Gantt's family and loved ones, Strozier's family and loved ones, as well as all those others who have now earned heaven because of COVID. Amen. May you all rest in heaven. Okay. I haven't been announced this week. Other than that, there's a new hip-hop postage stamp you get from the post office. So there's now three black-oriented stamps you can get. There's the Queen Alpha stamp that's still out there, the Harmony Sound stamps, and now there's the hip-hop stamps. Hip-hop is now 40 years old, so that's the reason that the hip-hop stamp is out. Also, there's now a campaign for folks to support Rochester black-owned restaurants. This week from 6 to 12, I'll put a link as well a list of the various restaurants you can support. Also, this week marks the 41st Minister Akilah Ife Festival in Elyria, Ohio. This year, all the events will be at the Kissing House. There are some contingent of Minister students that will be going. I will not be going. I wish all those going safe trip. Please be very careful. I've asked Ms. Gerald to have someone record the Thursday evening program, which is on Ms. Evans. So if I get that video by this week, I'll play it this Sunday instead of me talking. And if they don't send me the video, there'll be no video until the 19th. I'll take a break next Sunday out of respect for the festival. Amen. Next is Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He make me lie down in green pastures. He leads beside me still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. May the Lord bless those who read his holy word. Amen. Before I play the last four videos to close the program out, I'd like to thank all those who gave Bibles, gave donations. Thank all those who checked me during the week. Please continue to check on me during the week. Please check on those around you that need a little help. Check on your neighbors. Okay, we're going to close up with Bill Withers, Lean On Me. See if you want to help us all. Sound Coaching is going to come. And encourage me if you people get ready in that order. Amen. May he rest in peace, God.
Too hard living, but I'm afraid to die.
May you rest in peace, Sam Cook. This concludes verses to Doology Hour for Sunday, July 5th, 2020. Thank you all for supporting today's program. Please be very careful this week as you go about your daily activities. Wash your hands, wear your mask when you go outside. Please. For those going to Ohio, have a safe trip. Be safe. Be very careful. As I said before, if Mr. Gerald or his team did not send the video of the Thursday program where they honor Ms. Evans, if you don't send it to me, there'll be no video for Sunday the 12th. There'll be videos on the 19th. So I thank you all. I love you all. Take care of yourselves. Watch out for those who need a little help. And we'll see each other in 2 weeks. Love you all. Have a safe day of the week. Peace out.